Good evening. We gather as a community of faith, the Church of St. Bartholomew the Apostle, on this 23rd Sunday in Ordinary Time. We offer a warm welcome to all who are visiting from other parishes or from outside the local area. We're happy that you can join us at this Eucharist. At this time, please take out your phones and make sure that they are on silent or vibrate. Please stand, find someone you do not know, move out of your pew, and take a moment to extend a warm St. Bartholomew welcome. Please join in singing our entrance hymn, Healing River of the Spirit.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. The Lord be with you. Brothers and sisters, let us acknowledge our sins and so prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries. Lord Jesus, you are the Holy One of God. Lord, have mercy. Christ Jesus, you make the deaf hear and the mute speak. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you love the just. Lord, have mercy. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Lord God, heavenly King,
O God, by whom we are redeemed and receive adoption, look graciously upon your beloved sons and daughters, that those who believe in Christ may receive true freedom and an everlasting inheritance. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever. This section of the book of Isaiah contains the words of a prophet to God's people, exiled in Babylon. He encourages them that one day they will be free to return home to Jerusalem. This journey will be through the desert, but God will transform this barren wasteland to ease their passage home.
A reading from the book of the prophet Isaiah. Thus says the Lord, say to those whose hearts are frightened, be strong, fear not. Here is your God. He comes with vindication. With divine recompense, he comes to save you. Then will the eyes of the blind be opened, the ears of the deaf be cleared. Then will the lame leap like a stag. Then the tongue of the mute will sing. Streams will burst forth in the desert, and rivers in the steppe. The burning sands will become pools, and the thirsty ground springs of water. The word of the Lord.
The letter of James was written approximately 50 years after the death and resurrection of Jesus. It was addressed not to a particular community, but to Christians everywhere. Because of this, it is part of a group of New Testament letters called Catholic, that is, universal epistles. One of the trademarks of the Epistle of James is the need to act on God's word, not just listen to it.
A reading from the letter of St. James. My brothers and sisters, show no partiality as you adhere to the faith in our glorious Lord Jesus Christ. For if a man with gold rings and fine clothes comes into your assembly, and a poor person in shabby clothes also comes in, and you pay attention to the one wearing the fine clothes and say, sit here, please, while you say to the poor one, stand there, or sit at my feet. Have you not made distinctions among yourselves and become judges with evil designs? Listen, my beloved brothers and sisters. Did not God choose those who are poor in the world to be rich in faith and heirs of the kingdom that he promised to those who love him? The word of the Lord.
The Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Mark. Again, Jesus left the district of Tyre and went by way of Sidon to the Sea of Galilee, into the district of the Decapolis. And people brought to him a deaf man who had a speech impediment and begged him to lay his hand on him. He took him off by himself away from the crowd. He put his finger into the man's ear, and spitting, touched his tongue. Then he looked up to heaven and groaned, and said to him, "Ephphatha," that is, "be opened." And immediately the man's ears were opened, his speech impediment was removed, and he spoke plainly. He ordered them not to tell anyone, but the more he ordered them not to, the more they proclaimed it. They were exceedingly astonished, and they said, "He has done all things well. He makes the deaf hear and the mute speak." The Gospel of the Lord. Good evening, everyone. You know, I don't know about you, but does it ever feel like the world around us is just getting louder and noisier each day? Have you ever felt like that before? That's a resounding yes. Well, you know what? They tell us that we're more connected, more informed than ever before. But the question is, what are we actually connected to? And how exactly are we being informed? And so in a society that's constantly plugged into social media, streaming services, instant information at our fingertips, and really all the news media that is really a constant cacophony of information or sometimes misinformation. And so it's really hard to receive the voice of truth. It's really hard to discern what's true, what's real. And so, what are the effects of that? I know for myself and for so many others, the constant noise in the world is deafening. It's anxiety-inducing. And so we begin to lose the ability to distinguish for ourselves what's right, what's wrong, what's true, what's false. What's another effect? When we can't hear the voice of truth, we can't give voice to the truth. When we can't hear the voice of truth, we can't give voice to the truth. It's harder and harder to articulate what we believe in the midst of all the noise. And so, friends, the big question is, what's the remedy to all of that? What's the remedy to the constant pull and noise from the world around us. On this 23rd Sunday at Ordinary Time, Jesus gives us the remedy, the medicine, as it were, for the noise and anxiety and distractions. And it's the same remedy that he gives to the deaf man in our gospel. What is it? His word. Be opened. Friends, the word of Christ is the remedy to all the noise in the world. It's his word. And so in our gospel today, we see three beautiful moves that shape for us our invitation this weekend, and really the invitation for our time today. What's the first move that we see? We know that Jesus moves into the district of the Decapolis. Okay, so what's that all about? Well, friends, the Decapolis, it really just means 10 cities, a place very much influenced by Greek culture, and so very much influenced by people who were far from the Word of God. Probably a place that became so deaf to God's Word, they couldn't hear it anymore. They couldn't articulate it anymore. And so aren't we living today in a modern Decapolis, a culture which was at one time very much built on the Word of God, built on Christian values, but now very much influenced by the secular world view. And so more and more people, what are they doing? They are disaffiliating, not just from Christianity, but disaffiliating from religion itself, from what's of highest value, from what's really transcendent. And so we're becoming more and more deaf to God's word. And so what is Jesus's first act when he encounters this deaf man with a speech impediment? What does Jesus do? He took him away. He took him off by himself, away from the crowd. That's the first move, because Jesus knows that his word is the remedy to opening his senses. But what does he have to do? He has to remove him away from the city, away from the voices that have made him deaf. And so, my friends, what are the voices in our life that Jesus wants to bring us away from? Well, I think to begin with, it's the surrounding culture. Perhaps the films that we see, the music that we listen to, the media that we take in. And so Jesus' first invitation, come away from the noise. Come with me so that you can hear and listen to my voice. Okay, so what's the second move? Jesus puts his finger into the man's ear and touches his tongue and speaks the words, Ephata, be opened. And so friends, what does this mean spiritually for us, other than Jesus literally reconnecting us, putting us back online with himself, who is the Word? And so the second move, Christ speaks his word to us today, that word which is healing medicine, and he says, Ephatha, be opened. Come back into relationship with my word, which is spirit and life. And so finally, what happens? What's the third move? The man's ears are opened, his speech impediment removed, and he spoke plainly. Friends, once we receive the word and we're healed by the word of God, we can begin to hear again. We can hear again the voice of truth, and with hearing the word, we can now speak that word of truth to others. That's the third move, that once healed from deafness, we're called to speak. We're called now to be Christ for others and speak those same words to the world. Be opened. Hear the word of healing. So friends, as we hear God's word, and as we receive Jesus in the Eucharist this day, May we be healed from the deafness of the world around us. And as we are healed, may we go back out and speak. Speak as ambassadors of Jesus Christ, bringing others back online to his healing word. And once again, bring hope to a hurting world today. Amen. Let us please stand to profess our faith. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord, Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us men and for our salvation, he came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary, and became man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day, in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven, and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy Catholic and Apostolic Church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins. And I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. Let us bring our prayers before the Lord, who has the power to bring water to the desert and to bring mercy to us all.
For the church, that we may be healed of our deafness, so that we may hear God's invitations to service and recognize the cry of those who are suffering, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For a spirit of welcome and hospitality in our assembly, that all who join us for worship, community, and service may experience the love of Christ and a warm welcome, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For world leaders, that they may hear the cries of the poor and respond to them with restorative justice and practical assistance, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those killed in the school shooting in Georgia, Christian Angulo, Mason Schermerhorn, Christine Irimi, and Richard Aspinwall, may their souls rest in the Lord, and may God grant protection to all children and bring about an end to the horror of gun violence in our nation. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all those who lost their lives in the terrorist attack of 9/11, for the families and friends they left behind, and for an increased resolve to work toward an end to terrorism, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all the faithful departed, that they shall be raised up with all the angels and saints in heaven to live eternally in the glory of God, we remember especially Laura Swiderski, Maria Saliola, as well as Alfonso Pulis and Josephine Georgette Magrino, for whom this Mass is offered. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. Merciful God, open our eyes to your truth and our ears to your word, and grant us the courage to proclaim the good news throughout the world. We ask this in all the prayers we bring before you today, through your Son, who is Lord forever and ever. Amen. Thank you. Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God the Almighty Father. O God, who give us the gift of true prayer and of peace, graciously grant that through this offering we may do fitting homage to your divine majesty. And by partaking of the sacred mystery, we may be faithfully united in mind and heart through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just. Our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For you so loved the world that in your mercy you sent us the Redeemer to live like us in all things but sin, so that you might love in us what you loved in your Son, by whose obedience we have been restored to those gifts of yours that by sinning we had lost in disobedience. And so, Lord, with all the angels and saints, we too give you thanks as in exaltation we acclaim. Holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, And once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church, spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and Joseph, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever. The Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. Amen. The peace of the Lord be with you always. Let us offer each other the sign of peace.
Thank you.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. Thank you. Will all Eucharistic ministers to the sick and the homebound please come forward? As you go to visit the sick and the homebound, bring with you not only the Eucharist we have celebrated, bring also the Word of God that we have heard. Guarantee our love and our prayers, and please ask for prayers for us in return. Go in peace. Let us pray. Grant that your faithful, O Lord, whom you nourish and endow with life, through the food of your word and heavenly sacrament, may show benefit from your beloved Son's great gifts, that we may merit an eternal share in his life, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
Friends, just one brief reminder. Next year, there is a pilgrimage to Italy for the Jubilee out in Rome. And so if you're interested in that pilgrimage to Rome, the deadline is to sign up by September 23rd. September 23rd, okay? The Lord be with you. May Almighty God bless you, the Father and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. Go in peace, glorifying the Lord by your life.